Red Velvet's Yeri has seemingly responded to a YouTube channel accusing her of having Jennie disease, meaning she's trying to be like Jennie. The ridiculous assumption was made based on her quote recent dramatic outfit choices and makeup style, which doesn't make sense to me. And yes, it's the same Korean channel that will not be named who other K-pop idols have responded to and companies have threatened to sue. The only reason we're touching on this is because Yeri responded by saying, "I'm gonna live however I want. I pity people like them who can only make money by putting others down. Let's just focus on our own lives and spend each day with love and happiness." People loved how she addressed it, even though they thought she didn't need to even say anything because it was such an outrageous and unbelievable claim to begin with. Another response that unexpectedly came out yesterday was from former member of Le Sserafim, Kim Garam, the first we've heard from her since her departure from the group. The message was posted on her friend's social media, wanting to finally shed light on her side and her own thoughts. She pointed out, one, she has never beaten or harmed anyone. Two, she has never been forced to transfer. Three, she's never drank or smoked. Four, she's never bullied anyone. And five, she was just a regular student. She then proceeded to tell the story that we've actually heard HYBE describe of her standing up for her friend who she felt was wronged, which is why she admittedly ended up cursing at Eunso, the accuser. Though Garam does admit that looking back, it was very immature. She ended by saying she fought for her dreams, and even though it didn't last long, she'll never forget it. To back up her statement and side of things along with this message was the full school violence committee report, rather than the smaller portion we saw used against her initially, sparking questions of the reasons why HYBE didn't release the full thing in the first place. HYBE then actually put out a statement in response to this, basically saying because their contract with Kim Garam has been terminated, they have nothing else to say because it wouldn't be appropriate. However, Min Hee-jin, a door CEO under HYBE labels, has addressed the accusations and concerns surrounding her and NewJeans, who, side note, are certified monster rookies, now setting the all-time record for best-selling album by a girl group in first day sales. Anyway, Min Hee-jin responded in an interview by saying she heard from acquaintances about the allegations against her, photos in her studio of young girls, some seen wearing very little, some coming from movies that seemingly have themes revolving around older men and adolescent girls, having a member of NewJeans wear a shirt that says "Pimp is yours," ultimately deciding not to ignore this after all. She explained that the photos in her studio were just gifts from a few years ago. Regarding the shirt, she explained the slang word was taken to mean to decorate gorgeously, I'm guessing in a similar vein as the show Pimp My Ride. And as for the suggestive lyrics heard in NewJeans' song Cookie, she said, "We made this album with the heart of carefully baking cookies." Now, you guys can take that information and form your own opinions one way or the other now that you've heard what she had to say. The last serious topics are regarding idols who we won't be seeing for a while. It was just reported that Everglow's Aisha recently collapsed while preparing for an upcoming schedule. She was immediately rushed to the hospital and is undergoing several health examinations to figure out what's going on. The other idol is Super Junior's Eunhyuk after the recent news of his father's passing. You can see in this airport video where the members had seemingly just found out. Their label SJ released the news, also announcing that their world tour concert in Manila would be postponed. However, they still wanted to meet their fans in Manila, so basically held a giant fan meeting instead. From all accounts, the fans were respectful and understanding, to which the members continuously expressed their gratitude. This video of Lee Tzuk running to greet fans who waited until midnight for them actually gave me chills with all the context surrounding it, because it's heartwarming to see both fans and Super Junior trying to be positive for each other. And taking a page from their book, making sure to leave you guys with positivity, here are the things we can celebrate in K-pop. By the way, I'm gonna be at KCON LA next week. Attempt number 2 at trying to see Stray Kids in Bangchan. If you're gonna be there, come say hi. If not, follow me on Instagram. Now, I'm putting the Monsta X news in the positive section, despite I Am not resigning, because according to Starship, according to I Am himself, Monsta X is continuing as 6. While the other members have resigned, I Am said he personally feels the need to take on new challenges, but again reassured that the group will be 6 as always. Super glad we'll be getting Monsta X for many more years. Hopefully, we also get to celebrate even more anniversaries with Blackpink, who are celebrating their 6th. Fun fact, the photos you've been looking at are actually unreleased photos from their debut uploaded by a former YG creative director for their anniversary. EXID are also celebrating their 10th anniversary with a special live broadcast this week. Seeing them together now really makes you appreciate their amazing story and how far they've come. A group who's just getting started is ENHYPEN, whose album just debuted at number 6 on the Billboard 200. And then congrats to ATEEZ, who broke the top 3. Only the 5th boy group to do so, and out of those groups, the only one not from the big 4 companies. By the way, this is a real video from the official account of the Empire State Building. On the girl group side of things, aespa's Girls album just became the best-selling album ever by a K-pop girl group. Someone who's also no stranger to being on top of the mountain is Jessica, who just finished 2nd overall in the Chinese show called Sisters Who Make Waves, meaning she'll be making her return to the stage by debuting in this huge Chinese girl group. Can't wait to see it. I hope it goes as smoothly as possible, because we see, especially in the K-pop world, how hard it is for people outside of their home country to come in and quickly acclimate to everything. I definitely respect artists like British group New Hope Club, who go abroad, like come to Korea and really embrace things. They did TikTok challenges with ENHYPEN and Sunmi, performed on music shows. I especially have huge respect for Conan Gray, who also came to Korea, held a fan meeting in the traditional way you would see other K-pop artists and celebrities do, then went on Wendy's radio show, where he picked up a bunch of things that he would later show off at his concert.
I just learned today you're... I also learned...
And then, just like New Hope Club, Conan Gray performed on a music show. So what better way to end this video than with his take on the classic K-pop ending fairy?
Talking to you, it seems that you can just feel what a good person, what a good-hearted person you are.
Thank you, I've tricked you.